she pushed, the more he'd stay. She finally gave up cause she was worn out. That's when he decided to get born now. He was a rebel. When he was growing up, he was given toys, action figures and things for boys. So he went into his sister's room and had tea with dolls every day at 2. He was a rebel. As a teenager, he got good grades till he heard his parents rave. So he stopped doing work at home and he started spending time alone. He was a rebel. He dropped out of school at 17, started a job at a factory, got an apartment with friends. He had his fair share of hallucinogens. He was a rebel. His girlfriend said he looked so fine, with good skin and a strong jawline. So he got a tattoo on his face. It read, "I've been replaced." He was a rebel. He traveled around after that. His clothes were worn out and black. He smelled bad, he had long dreads that were wired into his head. He was a rebel. While traveling from town to town, he met someone who looked down, frowned, and said, "You should go to New Orleans. That place will set you free. Those people are rebels." So he hitchhiked to New Orleans, spent some time in her scene. The people were just like him, dreads and tats on every limb. They were rebels. He removed the tattoo on his face, went back to school, got all A's, got a job, a wife and kids, with a little white picket fence. And he stayed in New Orleans just to ditch that scene. And he remained there spayed and shaved, and for the rest of his days he was a rebel.